Hello, my dear students. Good afternoon, all of you. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. My name is Tazib sir, and today we are going to learn students new chapter. Okay, today we are going to learn a new chapter. So, my dear students, before starting, as per regular, let's check today's code, and then after we move on our session. So, today we are going to learn a new chapter. Okay, SEM 1 exam is gone, means chapter number 1 to chapter number 6 is done. Now here we are starting a chapter number 7. So now, my dear students, let's start here the chapter number 7. So let's check today's code, and then after we move on our new chapter. So let's check today's code. Today's quote is no one is perfect, that's why pencil have eraser. That's why pencils have a eraser. So now let's check her today's agenda, means today's contents, what we are going to learn, and then after, my dear students, we check. Okay, so my dear students, today's agenda means today's content is what we are going to learn. So today here we are starting a chapter number 7, fraction. Okay, first of all we already introduced a fraction in standard third. Already we have learned this fraction, but okay, not as a much more, not as a familiar chapter, as a multiple, as a addition, as a division, or as a any sums like that, word problems like that. So is not a very much familiar, that's why again we are do the further fraction. Okay, so some important topics, addition of fraction, subtraction of, as like that, and a new topic. Which new topic we are going to learn here? Like fraction and unlike fraction. Okay, in further advance a new topic of fractions. So we are going to learn this all topics. Okay, so first of all let's check our introduction of fraction, then after looking back of a fraction. Looking back means what we have done in third standard. Okay, that a basic concept and small things, that and understanding fractions better. How can we understand a fraction by better? Okay, easily means, and a new topic is that a like fraction and unlike fraction. Understood, my dear students? So now let's check here our chapter number 7, fraction. Okay, so one by one we learn the all things here. Okay, so now let's check here what is a fraction. Okay, so let's check here, my dear students. Introduction of fraction. A fraction represents the number of equal parts of whole. Okay, not a wall. Okay, W-A-L-L is not a wall. Okay, here is wall. Wall means a full part, pura, as like that. W-H-O-L-E, wall. Okay, wall. A fraction, fraction is word. A fraction represents the number of equal of a wall. Okay, fraction is what? Equal parts of the world means a full parts of any things. Okay, full parts of, see, as I am taking here example of a round shape, circle shape. Okay, circle, I am taking the full parts of the circle, and we do the two parts, equal two parts. So one parts it's called a fraction, and other parts is also called a fraction. But whole circle is what we say, wall part, pura parts, as like that. Understood, my dear students? So fraction, that is a up digit, up number, it's called a numerator, and a down digit, down south, it's called a denominator. What, my dear students? Understood? Fraction is upside is called a numerator, and downside it's called a denominators. Means up notes means up. Whenever we are see the fraction is upper digit, it's called a numerator digit, and down digit it's called a denominators. Okay, I hope you all are understood, my dear students. Okay, so fraction is equal to numerator upon denominator. Whenever we write the downside digit, it's called a down south or up north, but it's not a necessary. It's a common or simple and mathematical word is a denominator or numerator. Okay, down digit it's called a denominators and upper digit it's called a numerator. Okay, my dear students. So that both words you have to keep it in mind and you have to learn. Okay, what is the spelling of numerator? Numerator. Numerator. Numerators. Okay, and that and then a downside. It's called a denominators. Means denominator. Denominators. Okay, means whenever we write the down digit, it's called a denominators. Okay, it's the keywords of our fraction. Okay, denominators and numerators, both is our keywords of our fraction. So, I hope you all are understood, dear students, what are numerator and what are denominators. Now, you have a one doubt, what is a numerator and what is a denominator? So denominator is of equal parts make up a wall. Means what? Equal parts. A wall make a equal parts. And a numerator means a equal parts. Understood? Numerator means a equal parts, means same part, equal parts. And denominator it's called a of equal parts that make up a wall. Okay, by example we are going to learn. Okay, my dear students. Again we see fraction have a two parts. How many parts fraction have? Two parts, denominator and numerator. Again and again we are repeating, again and again I am repeating here for you. Okay, you have keep it in mind both words, numerators or denominators. Okay, first comes a numerator and then denominators. Numerator means what, dear students? Upside digit or downside digit? Upside digit. And numerator and denominator means downside digit. Okay, numerator means upside digit and denominator means downside digit. So see here, the top number is the numerator. It show the number of part to count. What, my dear students? The top number is the numerator. It shows the number of parts to count. Okay, and denominators means the bottom number is the denominator. The bottom number is the denominator. It shows the number of equal parts it takes to make a one a wall unit. Means a wall parts it's called a denominator and wall parts equal parts. Okay, some parts shows any specialization part. It's called a numerator. Okay, my dear students, I hope you all are understood better. Okay, so let's check here further. By example, we are understand. Okay, see how many circles? Four. Okay, so one by one, we take one circle. Okay, by a circle, we are understand what the fraction. Okay, see here. It's called a what? One or two. One is called a numerator and two it's called a denominators. Bottom side digit it's called a what, my dear students? Numerator. Okay, it shows a wall part. And upside is what? Shows the numbers that shows that are a part of the part of the what, my dear students? Number of part shows and a denominator it shows the wall part and numerator it just shows a part of number. Okay, wall parts of the number. So my dear students, here one circle and how many parts? Okay, one circle, see here, and one is colored filled yellowish. Yellow is shaded. See, one and two parts. So see here, two parts and one is shaded and one is a blank. Okay, that's why we write 1/2. What, my dear students? How can we call that digit? 1/2. Okay, it's a fraction. Okay, by as like that we write the fraction of this figure. Okay, now second figure, how many parts? 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 parts are there. So see here, we write in the denominators 4. Okay, and how many parts are shaded there? There are 2 parts shaded. How many parts are shaded there? There are 2 parts shaded. So 1 and 2 parts. That's why we are write 2 in a numerators. Okay, and then that's why write a 2 by 4 numerators or denominators. Okay, it's show the whole function 2 upon 4. 4 is a whole part and 2 is a shaded part. So 2 upon 4. Understood, my dear students? Okay, I hope you all are understood. Now a figure number 3. Okay, so how many circles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Total 6 parts. Okay, means there are 6 parts of a wall circle. Okay, so that's why we write a 6 in denominators. What, my dear students? That's why we are write in a denominator. That's why we are write in a 6 in a denominators. And how many parts are shaded in a wall circle? So 1, 2 and 3. 3 parts are shaded. Okay, so that's why we write in a numerators as a 3. Understood, my dear students? I hope you all are understood. Okay, now we move on the further figure number 4. Okay, so here let's say in whole circle, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 or 8. There are 8 parts. There are how many parts? 8 parts. Okay, there are 8 parts and 4 parts are shaded. There are 4 parts are shaded. Total 8 parts. That's total in whole circle 8 parts. So that's why we are writing in denominators 8. And shaded parts are 4. So that's why we say, my dear students, 4 a numerator. Understood? I hope you all are understood, my dear students. Again, I repeat, dear students, this wall circle, in wall circle, how many parts are there? 2 parts. Okay? In any things, any shape, we first of all, we check the how many parts are in any shapes. So, the total parts we write in the downside, means in a denominators, and a shaded part we write in a numerator. Understood, my dear students? Is our key, is our formula, is our method or process, whatever you called. Okay, so again I repeat a fourth figure. Okay, so here one circle, in circle 2 parts are there, so we write the 2 and as a numerator. Okay, and one part is a shaded, so we write a 1 as a numerator. Understood, my dear students? I hope you all are understood. Now a second figure. There are in circle, there are 4 parts in the wall circle. Okay, there are 4 parts in the circle. So there are 4 parts and 2 parts are shaded. So that's why we are write a fraction as 2 upon 4. Okay, then after a figure number 3, there are a 6 circle, there are a wall, a 6 circle. Okay, there are how many circles are there? There are 6 circle and 3 circles and 3 parts are shaded. Okay, not a 6 circle, 6 part of the 1 circle and 3 parts are shaded. So that's why we code a 3 upon 6, 3 by 6. Okay, then after the figure number 4. Figure number 4 is what, my dear students? Figure number 4. Total there are 8 parts. Okay, total there are 8 parts. Okay, so 8 parts, that's why we are write 8 as a denominators. Okay, and numerators means a shaded parts. So how many parts are shaded there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 parts are shaded. So that's why we write the 4 upon 8. Understood now? Now let's take a second example. Okay, so here a 4 figure. Okay, 1 figure. See, is 1 part. Okay, what shows that? No any parts. 1 circle, 1 round. It's a fully filled. So that's why 1. 1. ओके, वन इज वन, नो पार्ट्स, नॉट शेडेड, फुल्ली ओनली शेडेड सर्कल, दैट्स वाई वी राइट द वन. देन आफ्टर वन एज इट इज, देन आफ्टर अ सेकेंड सर्कल. इन सेकेंड सर्कल हाउ मेनी पार्ट्स आर देयर माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स? टू पार्ट्स आर देयर, देर आर अ टू पार्ट्स, ओके, वन वन और टू. तो दैट्स वाई एज अ न्यूमरेटर वी राइट द टू, ओके, एंड डिनोमिनेटर्स वी राइट द टू, एंड न्यूमरेटर्स वन पार्ट इज शेडेड, ओके, दैट्स वाई वन अपॉन टू, वन बाई टू. एंड द नेक्स्ट फिगर वन टू थ्री एंड फोर, फोर पार्ट्स आर देयर, ओके, देर आर अ फोर पार्ट्स. हाउ मेनी पार्ट्स आर देयर माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स? देर आर अ फोर पार्ट्स. सो एज अ न्यू डिनोमिनेटर्स वी राइट राइट अ फोर, ओके, एंड अपसाइड वॉट वी राइट माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स? अपसाइड वन पार्ट इज अ शेडेड, सो दैट्स वाई वी राइट अपसाइड अ वन, वन अपॉन फोर, ओके. अंडरस्टूड माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स? आई होप यू ऑल आर अंडरस्टूड betterly. Now a question, now a further figure, not a question here dear students, 1 2 3 and 4, four parts are there, okay. So how many parts are shaded of a yellow or greenish color? 1 2 or 3, okay, one part is blank, okay, total four parts, 2 plus 2, four parts, and three parts is shaded, that's why it's called a 3 upon 4. What my dear students? 3 upon 4. Understood, my dear students, what we are going to do? Okay. Now let's looking back. This all things we have done in a third standard. A fraction shows part of the wall. Okay, is a common and sweet and salt. A definition. Introduction or a looking back. A fraction shows a part of wall. Okay. A fraction shows a part of wall. Okay, my dear students. The wall can be region or a collection. Okay. A wall can be region or a collection. Okay, so in a one star, how many parts are there? In a one star, how many parts are there? In circle, there are five parts are there. In a circle, five parts in a circle. Okay, so here is what we are taking, here a star. Okay, here a star. See the star, 1 2 3 4 and 5. In star, five parts are there. Okay. So the dear students, the wall can be region or collection. Okay, so 2 by 5 of the star is a redhead. Okay, means 5 is what? Total parts. In 2 parts is what? Redhead, shaded or 2 red parts. Okay, so 2 by 5 of the star is redhead. Means what? 5 out of 2. 5 out of 2. Star is redhead, as like the wall part is 5 and 2 of the star is redhead. Okay, so see here how many stars are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 2 by 5. See here, first two stars are redhead. Okay, 2 by 5 of the stars are redhead. So all 3 is a blank. Understood, my dear students? I hope you all are understood these all things. Okay. Now we move on our session. Fraction is a very easy or enjoying topic. Okay, my dear students, it's not a boring topics in a maths. So that's why maths is not a boring subject, my dear students. Keep it in mind all things. Okay. So in fractions, fraction is a very interesting chapters, very interesting topic. And new sessions, we are by the activity, we are by the gaming. We are going to learn, we are something catch up on new things. Okay, so now first of all we hear only the introductions. First of all we learn here the fractions, okay, common or introductions of a fraction and common things. Okay, no need to do further. Okay, now here only we learn the simply things, simplify things. Okay, now a new topic, understanding fractions better. Understanding fraction better. Charts were beginning paint with the glitter for the school annual decoration. The Joyce chart. Okay, first chart. See this first chart. Okay, is a name of a girl, Joyce. Okay. So my dear students, she says that a two has a painted 1/2 her charts. Okay, they both have a two parts, and they both are shaded a one parts. Understood, my dear students? It means a simple or equal distribution. Okay, now some lines are important for us. Let's check here, my dear students. We can see that through a both have a painted half their charts. We can see that through the both have a printed half their charts. Means they both printed a half of the chart, yellowish color. They have both not painted the same amount. See, Joyce's and Priyanka's both are shaded a same equal part. See, is Joyce's printed a big part and Priyanka's print a small part. Okay, so that's why they have both not painted the same amount. So both would have painted the same amount if both the charts were the same size. Okay, both would have painted the same amount if both the charts were the same size. Okay, for a function, for the fractions to be equal, they should be from the same wall or equal size. Okay, what my dear students, for function to be equal, they should be from the same wall or equal sized walls. Okay, again I repeat, my dear students, what things we are do. Okay, we can see that both have painted half their charts. They have both are not painted the same amount. Both would have painted the same amount if the both the charts were the same size. For a functions to be equal, they should be from the same wall or equal size wall. Understood, my dear students? Means what to do for a fractions to be equal, they should be from the same wall. Okay, means we do the same wall part. Okay, now we move on further. Let's check, my dear students, by example we are going to learn. So fraction part of the wall. What, dear students? The fraction part of wall. So see, the first is what wall part is shaded, means a one. Okay, now a second, a rectangular shape or a circle shape, both shapes are there. Okay, there are both shapes. So in circle or rectangular, how many parts are there? One or two. Okay, both have a two parts. So that's why in a denominators we write two, and a shaded part is a one. Yellow is shaded parts, that's why we write the 1/2. Means what? 1/2. Okay, and here how many parts are there, my dear students? Total three parts are there, and one part is shaded by a green color. Okay, so 1, 2, or 3. See, let's check. 1, 2, or 3. Okay, understood, my dear students? Okay, now question number 4, means figure number 4. 1, 2, 3, or 4. Figure number 4. Okay, there are how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, or 4. 4 parts are there. Okay, there are 4 parts. Okay, and one part is shaded. Okay, by a yellowish color. So 1/4. Okay, Now further 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 parts are there. There are 5 parts total and 1 part is shaded by a purple color. So that's why we say 1 upon a 5. And then further in whole circle total 6 parts are there. How many parts are there? 6 parts. And 1 is a red part are shaded. So that's why 1 upon a 6. Okay. And then further a pink. Okay. Pink is 1 shaded and other is blank. Total how many parts are? 8 parts are there. So 1 upon 8. And here is what, my dear students? Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or 10. There are 10 parts. Okay. Total 10 parts. And 1 part is shaded by a light green color. Okay. So 1 upon 10. And last one, how many circles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 or 12. There are 12 circles. There are 12 parts. In 12 parts, only one part is shaded. So that's why 1 upon 12. Understood, my dear students? I hope you all are understood. Okay, now further. Okay, our new topic is what, my dear students? So let's check our new topic. Like fractions and unlike fraction. Okay, like fraction and unlike fraction. So first of all, we learn what is the like fraction. Fraction you all learn. Okay, we studied all words of a fractions. So like fraction is what, my dear students? Fractions that have the same denominators are called the like fraction. What? Fractions that have the same denominator are called the like fractions. See this example of like fraction. Again and again repeats. Denominator is what, my dear students? Denominator is a down digit. Okay? And numerator is upper digit. So see here. Fractions that have the same denominators are called the like fractions. So what we are seeing here in like fraction, only denominators. Denominators are same, means the down digit are same. It's called a like fraction. See this example. Okay, means my dear students, a top or down. Down digit are same, means here see 3, 3. Otherwise 5, 5. 10, 10, any example, but same number in both fractions, so it's called a like fraction. Understood, my dear students? Now we move on the unlike fraction. What is unlike fraction? Is opposite, like and unlike both. Okay, both opposite words. So same things here. Okay, in like fraction is what? What is like fraction? Is a denominator are same and here difference. So fractions that have the different denominators are called unlike fraction. Okay, fractions that have two different denominators are called unlike fractions. Okay, 3 upon 5 and 2 upon 7. So see these both denominators, 5 and 7, both are different to each other. Okay, they both are different to each other, my dear students. Okay, so I hope you all are understood like fraction. What is a like fraction? Is denominator are same, means a down digit are same, and in unlike fraction down digit are difference. Okay, my dear students, I hope you all are understood betterly. Now we move on our example of like and unlike fraction. See, like or unlike fraction, same denominators and different denominators. See here, total how many figures are there? 1, 2 and 3. 3 figures are there. Okay, in the whole figure, how many parts are there? 4, 4, 4. See here, so we write the as the denominators 4. 1, 2, 3 means 4, 4, 4. Here how many parts are shaded? 1 upon 4 parts are shaded. Here 2 upon 4th part are shaded. Here 3 upon 4th parts are shaded. So that's why denominators are same. See, 4, 4 or 4. Same denominators. It's called a like fraction and unlike fraction means different denominators. See, 1 upon, here total parts 2. and one part is shaded. So 1 upon 2, here 1 or 2 or 3, 3 parts are there. That's why denominator is 3 and 2 parts are shaded. So it's 2 upon 3. See, this both are difference. And now last fourth, 1, 2, 3 and fourth. Okay, so fourth parts are there and three parts are shaded by yellow color, by a pink color. So that's why we write the 3 upon 4. So see here the in green colors, denominators are different. It's called a unlike fraction and denominators are a same. It's called a like fraction. So my dear students, this topic and the fractions we are learn here, and further tomorrow we are going to learn or exercise a new topic or new exercise related to this all topic. Okay, I hope you all are enjoying this fraction. Okay, I hope you all are understood. Okay, thank you so much my dear students. Thank you.